Three, two.
Everyone, and welcome back to this week's Weekly Newscast. Hey Jacob, I have a question for you.
What is it?
How does your presence make an impact?
Well, there's plenty of ways that your presence can make an impact, whether it's through sports, helping your community, or making your own personal legacy. Let's start off by looking at a recap of the boys' basketball season.
Small town Hollywood, dreams, I know that everything that glitters ain't gold. I know this ain't always good as it seems, but tell me till you get it, how could you know?
How could you know?
I'm Ezell Perry, student athlete here at Ben Davis. And for being an athlete here, we always hear a lot about the standard, culture, and the legacy left behind us. I don't really know much, so I decided to go and ask new head football coach Russ Mann. Let's go see what he knows.
First, honored, humbled. Second, then it was like, I'm ready for this and all the new roles that come with football. They had a lot of different titles and positions and this is a whole new title. The one thing with some transitions that I've had from different going into different programs and coaching in some of the different area schools is that you embrace the traditions and you embrace the history. You're not there to fix it, and there's nothing broken here. And there are 9 football state championships, and there are some tremendous past coaches. Beginning with, you know, Coach Delahan coming in here in the 80s, passing it to Coach Allen, who's now the head coach at IU, to Coach Kirshner, to Coach Simmons. Those are big shoes to fill. There are cultures in place here that are beautiful for young men of a football program. There are things that do not need touched. And Coach Simmons had us, the reason why this hire was an internal hire was the amount of pieces that would remain in place. And Coach Simmons had us ready. Like, whatever success that we would potentially have next year would have happened with Coach Simmons as well. Like, there are not things that need fixed.
Come on, Giants. Come on, Giants.
You start to think about the history, the tradition, what it means to be a Ben Davis Giant, and it's special.
I do never give up. I do never give up. I do never give up.
To improve the program because this is the first ever
season for boys high school volleyball that the IHSAA has put a platform out there for us. I really want, number one is effort. Effort over anything. Secondly is attitude, bringing a positive attitude every day, working hard, and learning the game. We are going to bring together the best guys out there to hopefully learn the sport, get better each day, and the IHSAA has now given boys volleyball a platform to become a high school sport.
Good morning. My name is Zion Taylor, and I'll be giving you the weekly update on sports.
Girls tennis had three matches against Avon, Mooresville, and Cardinal Ritter, and they have a match tonight against Pike. Boys golf also had three matches at West Chase and against Avon and Lutheran. Girls track and field had their first meet Tuesday against Carmel and Pike, and they have another tonight at Franklin Central. The softball team won their first game against Pike 8-7 on Tuesday. Tonight they have a game against Covenant Christian. The baseball team opened up their mid-conference play with a win over Pike, but turned around and lost to Pike Wednesday. Now they have a game tomorrow at 11. Boys track and field had their first meet Wednesday, and they beat Warren Central. And now they have BD relays tomorrow morning. Be sure to follow at Giant Athletics on Twitter to keep up with sports. Good job and good luck, BD.
That's it for sports this week. Zion Taylor, BDTV.
Thank you for that info on sports. Now let's move on and take a look at how people are forging their own personal legacy.
Youth entrepreneurship is on the rise like never before. Now let's take a deeper look into how some of our Phillip and Davis students are building their own legacy and building their own business.
Hello, my name is Irvin Cruz and I attend Ben Davis High School. I started to cut hair when it was fall 2021. What really inspired me to cut hair was one of my friends down there in Chicago. He started to cut hair and I really liked the way he cut hair. And I was like, why not try it? So I tried it from there. The advice I'd give somebody who wanted to start a business is trust the process, give it time, and try to build clientele, like post your work on social media and all that. And just remember that it takes time. The most rewarding part about being a barber is meeting new people and making people feel confident with themselves and just them leaving the shop with a smile. And you can follow my Instagram at Cruz Cuts for more information.
What's an internet legacy? In short, it's the digital footprint you leave behind every time you log on to the internet. It sounds sort of intense, but it doesn't have to be. You can use the internet to create a positive legacy that spreads wider than just your account and impacts everyone that signs on after you. YouTube was created in 2005 and saw the rise of the online creator. People like Rhett & Link, Emma Chamberlain, and Liza Koshy all started online and have now made appearances on The Tonight Show, Vogue, and the Met Gala. They legitimized their career path and created a legacy for others to follow. So, how do you create your own legacy on the internet?
On March 10th, our very own speech state champion Abdulrahman Aminu was recognized for his achievements at the superintendent board meeting. He has an insight into the work he's put in and the legacy he'll be leaving behind.
I was forced to do speech by my big sister because she wanted to do it, so she was like, we're both gonna do it. And then after she left, it was, I don't know, I just felt like it was my responsibility to stay. I recently won a state champion and programmed oral interpretation for state speech. I don't think we've had, well, we definitely haven't had any state champions on the speech or debate team during the time I've been here. So I think it's just like I'm setting an example, or like I've started something that will make people want to advance to be state champions. I think that I want to see more of what I saw this year. This year I really see the team coming together and, you know, putting in the work that they need to put in order to attain their goals. And I think I just want to see more of that.
Victor Loyami,
Nani Binion,
BDTV.
Hello, my name is Prez Ajayi, and I'm here to give you your weekly weather updates. Last week was a bit warmer than usual, so let's see what next week has in store for us.
Friday will be a high of 76 and a low of 53. Saturday will be a high of 76 and a low of 56. Sunday will be a high of 64 and a low of 44. Monday will be a high of 67 and a low of 43. Tuesday will be a high of 61 and a low of 44. Wednesday will be a high of 64 and a low of 38. And lastly, Thursday will be a high of 72 and a low of 45.
That's all we have for weather this week. And don't forget to have a great day. Prez Ajayi, BDTV.
Thanks for that weather forecast, Prez. Many people here in Wayne Township are working together to make an impact on their community. Let's go take a look at some of those.
Alors, classe, n'oubliez pas que vendredi vous allez... Daniel, why are you on your phone right now?
Oh, sorry, but wouldn't it be cool if we could decorate our caps this year?
Didn't you know? This year you can decorate your caps.
Wait, didn't you hear? Look, so they're right here. Graduates may decorate their caps to celebrate their accomplishments. All cap decorations must follow the school dress code.
For anyone who missed it, the class of 2023 now gets to decorate their caps. That's right, Mr. Mendenhall?
That's exactly right. So this year, the administration, Dr. Walters, Dr. Butts, and Ms. Squire wanted to give our students an opportunity to celebrate their accomplishments, whether it's something they did in high school, something about their family and their heritage. We want to give you guys the opportunity and all of our students the opportunity to celebrate who they are by decorating their caps, as long as it fits within the school dress code and it's not against the rules.
That's true. So make sure you use this opportunity to decorate your caps to show your different ethnicities and cultures, but make sure you follow the rules so we can leave a legacy for the upcoming generations.
Mr. Hayes has been at Ben Davis for 18 years. The keyhole has been here since 1933, and the spotlight has been here since 1935.
We've just been adding on to all the good work that was done before we got here. We create content is what we try to do in here. I like to think that we represent a voice of the student body at Ben Davis.
I joined this class my sophomore year because I really like to read and write. I'm the editor-in-chief, so I'm kind of the go-to person that people go to when they have questions or they need help with anything, with writing stories or doing an interview.
What will be the long-lasting impact that you will leave on the people around you? In other words, what will be your legacy?
Well, that was very informational, and now we know more about the amazing legacy of our school's newspaper and how it's being continued. We'll wear BDTV.
If you really think about it, there's a lot of musical history throughout Ben Davis.
Yes. Now let us introduce you to the music legacy throughout the years for Ben Davis.
Back then, BD was known as Ben Davis. With 14 state marching band titles, BD held a consecutive title for the longest. The Ben Davis Marching Band was founded in 1918. Our band sets the Indiana state record for most Class A consecutive wins for classes 1984 through 1988. They also performed for six U.S. presidents at their inaugurations.
Our orchestra has a legacy of students qualifying for state, solo, and ensemble for over a decade now. Also, they've been competing at the highest category of organizational ISMA contests for over a decade, scoring only gold ratings. And they've performed at Disney World four times.
Speaking of instruments, you know we all have an instrument inside our body, an instrument that all singers rely on, such as our choir.
Choir has been a part of Ben Davis since it was built, with Purple Air's concert choir being its oldest choir. Back then, there wasn't as many as there are today, but the main ones were Premier's Sound Stations, which we call today Sounds, and Purple Air's. Sounds had two state championships in 2011 and 2012, and then there's Premier's with their flashy dancing and mesmerizing vocals. Their choir always had recognition when it came to show choir.
Hello everyone, my name is Danielle Williams, here with your community calendar. Today, Friday the 14th, is the FAFSA deadline, so make sure all paperwork and applications are turned in. Next week is Prom Spirit Week. To kick it off is Zoom Attire Day. Make sure you come in your nicest top and most comfy bottoms. Tuesday is Just Like a Celebrity Day. Wednesday is Country Club versus Country Day. And Thursday is a Club A Day. And those planning to participate in the 2023 band season, there's going to be a meeting held in the auditorium at 7 p.m. Friday is the last day to purchase prom tickets, and also for Spirit Day is International Dress Day. Saturday, April 22nd, is prom. so make sure you come nicely dressed and ready to party.
All right, everyone, that's all I have for Community Calendar. Danielle Williams, BDTV.
When it comes to legacy, Ben Davis has a high reputation in that regard, whether it's athletics, academics, music, and even our art programs. Let's ask around the art department to learn a little bit more about the legacy of our SWEAT event.
I'm Justin Allison. I'm the department chair for the art department here at Ben Davis High School. In 2004, Larry Hurt, who was an art teacher here at Ben Davis for many, many years, decided that he wanted to create an art show for seniors that would happen every year. He had created Arts Alive in 1985, which is a biannual festival that we do throughout the whole township. So since that happened every other year, he wanted to do something that would happen every year and wanted to help celebrate our seniors and their time here at Ben Davis. So since this is a senior-only art show, it's really a celebration of our seniors. Now, some of those seniors have been at Ben Davis and in Wayne Township their entire school careers, so it can be a celebration of their creative journey throughout their time in Wayne. Some students just join us like right in their senior year or their junior year, so it's a much smaller journey. It's not a contest, it's just really a celebration of the visual arts and our students at the end of their senior year.
SWEAT is a great way for our seniors to put their hard work on display and showcase their talents, so consider supporting them this year on May 20th from 7 to 9:30 p.m. in the Commons. I'm Zane Skabinski, BDTV.
Have you ever walked out of the front office and noticed plaques honoring our alumni on the wall? The wall was put up in October of 2002. Let's ask Ms. Dominique for more information on our Ben Davis Wall of Fame.
The wall here is to honor our alumni that graduated from Ben Davis, that had high achievement and made a big impact in our world and society. The purpose of the wall is to recognize Ben Davis School graduates who since graduated and have demonstrated a high level of achievement in their field and who had made a significant contribute through achievement, service, and leadership. What it takes, again, is to have demonstrate high level of achievements in your field and made a significant contribute to the world and our society through service and leadership. So if you just take a look at the wall, we have people who have been in the military. We have people who's been on radio stations that made a great impact, you know, to our students and in our country.
Jada, I love you. G.I. Jane 2, can't wait to see it.
Whoa. Wow. And it was a Jane joke.
Keep my wife's name out your mouth.
It was a harmful moment to his legacy because of the simple fact that black actors have to work 10 times harder for certain titles like an Oscar. Now, the joke may have been insensitive, but with such a violent reaction that feeds into the stereotype that black men are aggressive and not emotionally intelligent. Many viewers may have seen this and ran with the idea that black men are ghetto and classless.
And that's a wrap on this week's newscast. Remember to ask yourself, how does my presence make an impact?
There's plenty of ways, whether it's through your own personal actions, working with your community, participating in sports, and so on.
I'm Skylon Johnson.
I'm Jacob Meskimen.
And remember,
if it's about you and me, it's on BDTV.